It never got better, really. Just a few thoughts on what's going on in this world today. I'm fed up of living in this nasty duality. And I'm fed up of waiting to start my NCC community. I remember days when you could write hit songs about flowers and rainbows and people weren't too worried or scared to listen to them. Now I see more and more videos of protesters fighting the police on the street, because the protesters want their freedom, or what they thought was freedom. I frankly find it depressing to have to watch and depressing to even be here right now. People are subjected to a control system, and they have to fight that control while others give in, even thinking themselves good for doing so. This is the Orion Wars again. Here on Earth. It's come here and this is its last stand. The GFL will nip it in the bud and end it forever. I personally don't think there's much point in protesting. Why? Because people have protested since the 70s and nothing changed. The wheel of fate kept on rolling and rolling, gaining more and more momentum, until it got to where it is today, a state where people are divided and some are even fighting each other to maintain their opinion while the real terrorist goes along with its plan to demonize society. People knew back in the 70s. They knew back in the 60s and probably even beforehand that this was the plan for humanity on Earth. Yet they did nothing. They kept shopping, they kept socializing, they kept going to church. Nobody did anything. Now it's at a point where our hand is forced. We have no choice but to make different choices now. I'm all for starving out the deep state by not buying at their stores. Shop locally. Stop shopping at Walmart. Shop mom and pop. Don't buy foods from the large companies, Nestle's, Christie's, Kellogg's, Heinz, General Mills, Coca-Cola. Starve them of the one nutrient they need, money. Really, folks, we're at the point where we need to do something. We need to take back our power. Are you still watching the news? Still have cable even? Why? Keep your internet and cut the cable company off. Why pay AT&T, Rogers, etc. because they're cabal owned as well? All big businesses. Stop dealing with big business. Starve them out. If it's going to hurt you to not get to watch TV on the weekends, imagine the pain others are feeling when they get pepper sprayed and handcuffed for protesting for your rights. We should have demanded better for ourselves long ago. But people just let the government decide what was best for us. Now look. The government decided what was best for us was masks and staying at home, and people are fed up after 6 months of this. I don't blame them. Some of our children won't be going back to school because of mask laws. They'll be homeschooled instead. What we thought of as normal is gone. Admit it. What's it going to take for you to do something? Fight the establishment? Bring it down? What? In Canada on September 15, some people have decided to enact civil disobedience. They're not going to wear masks anymore. This is more like it. Solid action. In Berlin they are sitting in protest at the government buildings until all politicians are taken out of power and replaced. There'll be more. Lots more. People will get more and more creative about how they plan on taking the deep state down. I believe it could mean more razing of cities and even murders of some Illuminati members. Don't think this will go away. It's not going to. What did they do in France and Germany during the Second World War? There was a resistance movement then too. They did whatever they had to in order to win the war, and if this meant killing someone, then they killed them. World War II never ended, folks. And it's resurfacing again. Nobody's dropped a bomb. Nobody's shot anyone else. But we're at war. The answer is we have to become more conscious. Conscious shopping. Conscious of how we use our money, how we spend our time, where we work, and we have to keep envisioning a better future for humanity. We have to stop feeding the beast.